While women have made modest gains, the new book, The Male Factor, gives us information on how men...
Women may have made great strides in the workplace over the past few decades, but a new book suggests women may be inadvertently hurting their careers with their own behaviors. It's called The Male Factor. Shaunti Feldhahn is the book's author. She is here along with Donnie Deutsch, chairman of advertising agency Deutsch, Inc. Good morning to both of you.
When I was working on Wall Street, one of my jobs, one of my main jobs, was working with large Japanese banks. One of my main jobs was analyzing the Japanese financial system and making recommendations to the decision makers at the top of the company about which direction we go and what's happening on the ground right now. And I needed to dig into that a lot. When you go into a foreign culture, you know that you don't understand exactly how they think. You go in expecting, right? You go in knowing, okay, I better do a little work ahead of time so that I am sure that I know how what I'm going to do or say here is going to be perceived, right? So you go in and you dig into it so you know, okay, you say this, you don't say this. Like, for example, I would take my business card and I would just originally just kind of hand it out and they'd hand me theirs and I'd walk on and, oh, no, 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 no. If any of you have worked with Asia, you know the business card presentation is a ceremony. And if you take it and go, thanks, and walk on, it's like this huge insult. The number of times that I did that when I was sort of new in the job before somebody took me aside and said, we have to talk about this. You can't do that. And so you realize if you want to be effective, you have to understand what is in their mind. Well, guess what? I realized in all this research that in some ways there is an internal male culture that is every bit as real as if you were walking into a foreign country, and every bit as important to understand those unspoken expectations, how something is going to be perceived, so that we as women can be that much more effective. One more tool in our toolbox. That much more effective, and here's the key for a lot of us, and we can remove some obstacles that we may not have even known were there. And I did it two different ways. I spent a number of years interviewing every man I came across and asking them questions about how they felt in certain situations, you know, with a wife or a girlfriend, sort of a personal relationship, and then also recognized there was this massive workplace application of this. What are you thinking in the workplace? How does this affect the female colleagues that you have? What is your view when someone says or does this, and how does that affect how that woman is viewed in the workplace? And basically built up this stable of knowledge. I've interviewed and surveyed more than 3,000 men over the last 8 years. And I mean, let me tell you, ladies, I talked to every guy I came across. I mean, heaven help the poor man stuck next to me on the airplane for 2 hours. I mean, seriously. But it enabled me in these candid conversations. I had no idea what this man's name was. I just knew he was the guy in 2B. You know, he could be completely candid about what they really think in a way that often we will never hear otherwise. But it is knowledge that we need to have. This is also backed up not just by all of these interviews, but over the years I've commissioned 3 scientific, nationally representative surveys of men that cost me a lot of money in order to get reliable surveys. It's very much of a science. And so you really have to do this in a very, very systematic way. I hired the man who used to be the chief of survey design at the Census Bureau to help me design these surveys. And so in the end, I got this really reliable data on what men are very privately thinking that impacts us as women, but we would never hear otherwise. One of those things is that women have the capacity to process thoughts and emotions at the same time. Okay? Men don't. Let's take this the next step. What does that mean? If they see you being, quote unquote, emotional, they think you're not thinking clearly either as a woman. And that is not true. We assume getting emotional is confined to one thing, getting visually upset and teary-eyed, and it's not. I was talking to one consultant who, he's one of those guys that flies back and forth across the country Monday to Thursday, you know? I feel sorry for those people, but basically, so he leaves the house Monday morning and he's gone until Thursday night, and he's a growth management kind of consultant, and he was working with this one company in Seattle, and he told me that he was working with this one woman called Nicole, and he said, I just didn't like her. I don't know why, I just didn't like her. She just rubbed me the wrong way, and I had to work really closely with her, and I kept trying to get her moved to another project because I just didn't like her. And he said, it became such an issue that I'd call back home to my wife, you know, back he was based here, I'd call back home to my wife, and she would say, you know, how's it going, honey? He'd say, fine. And she'd say, have you been talking to Nicole again? He said, that's how big of an issue it was. And so finally she said, you know, let's figure, why don't you like Nicole? What is it? And he said, I just don't know. And he said, finally, he realized she asked a lot of why questions. Why did you do that? Why did you choose that particular pricing? Why did you do this? What was your thinking here? Blah, blah, blah. And he said, she wasn't asking how questions or what questions. She was asking why questions. And I feel like she was trying to challenge me and undermine me, especially in front of other people. You know, she would ask these questions in a boardroom, and I felt like she was saying, you have no idea what you're doing. Now remember, this is that insecurity talking, right? Okay, which 3/4 of men said that they have. This is a big issue for 3/4 of men. And he told his wife this, and she's like, honey, she's not challenging you. She's just trying to understand. And he said, really? And she's like, yeah, she's just asking a question. And he said, eventually, he's like, okay, I see that. And eventually, they worked together enough. He said, we became really good friends. He and Nicole became really good friends. And the whole last year of the project, they worked together really well together. And as they were wrapping that up, they went to dinner one night. And he said, you know, Nicole, when we started working together, I just didn't like you. And she's like, I know, but why?